Born May 4th, 1946 in Wailuku, Maui, Eddie would become one of the finest big wave riders Hawaii has ever produced. As a symbol of aloha, self-sacrifice, and humanity, he will always be remembered.
Eddie is a wonderful person. We used to work together as a lifeguard. He's a good lifeguard. He's a good surfer. He loves to surf at the Waimea and wherever the waves are big.
Eddie formed a unique relationship with Waimea. Few surfers who have attempted to ride her towering walls have known the bay as well as he did. A true Hawaiian, Eddie loved the sea, and it was during one of his ocean adventures that he would return to her embrace. Eddie was a crew member aboard the Hokule'a, a replica of an ancient Hawaiian sailing vessel, when tragedy struck. The ship capsized in heavy seas, and the lives of all aboard were in jeopardy. Eddie paddled away in search of help and was never seen again. The other crew members stayed with the boat and were saved.
In actuality, only one person on that canoe that could possibly, if anybody had a chance, would have been Eddie. And David said, no, Eddie, you know, you stay with the ship and everything. And but he really, he begged to go for help. So he went, you know. But the reason he went was because he loved his crew members.
For more than a decade now, the phrase, Eddie would go, has been both a slogan and a mantra among big wave surfers, urging them to push the boundaries of the sport. Before 1999, the Quicksilver in Memory of Eddie Aikau Big Wave Invitational had been held only twice to completion. The Eddie, as it's known, can only be held in the largest of waves because it is dedicated to a surfer of the greatest courage and the largest of hearts.